in Manchester, New Hampshire, is Reverend Gene Robinson, Episcopal Bishop of New Hampshire, the first openly gay priest to be ordained a bishop of a major Christian denomination. He naturally supports same-sex marriage. Reverend Robinson, how are you reacting to this decision?
I'm certainly disappointed in the decision as it came down, but I'm also hopeful about this movement that we're in. You know, as a Christian, as a bishop of the church, I know from 1 John chapter 4 that where love is, God is. It says that if we know love, we know God. And I know in my own relationship with my partner of over 20 years, I have learned so much about the self-giving love of God. Because that's how my partner treats me. And it's why the church values marriage. We believe it's a place where God can show up and where we can learn about that kind of self-giving love and why anyone who loves deserves it.
Dr. Garlow, what's wrong with that argument?
Well, it's interesting he picks on one part of the scripture and ignores all the rest. The Bible starts with a marriage, it ends with a wedding of a bride and groom, and all the way in between, it lifts up one model, that is marriage is one man, one woman. Even when Jesus spoke on this.
We live in a country, it's not a Christian country.
I recognize that, but he introduced the Bible and extracted one particular passage. If we're going to use the Bible, let's use all of it. And if we're going to use the Bible, let's use it appropriately. It speaks very specifically on the act of homosexuality and Jesus' affirmation for marriage of a man and a woman.
Dr. Garlow, Leviticus says that lying with men is an abomination, but it condemns the act of eating shrimp and lobster together, as well as wearing material woven of two kinds of material. You ever do any of those?
And have you ever found any of those kind of concepts that are expressed there to be consistent through the rest of the Bible? People extract that.
So what happened?
It was there for particular purpose, for illustrative functions. And then when you go on into the rest of the Bible, whether you start with Genesis 19, or you go to Romans 1, or 1 Timothy 1.
Isn't the Bible contradictory a lot?
No, it's not contradictory at all. It is consistent all the way through that marriage consists of one man and one woman. What's interesting to this, Larry, is wherever the government has a vested right to redefine marriage, it also has a perceived right to try to silence those who disagree with it. And there's a loss of rights that comes when same-sex marriage is validated by the government.
Do you believe that Reverend Robinson is therefore against his faith?
He actually is. That's why the Episcopal Church has plummeted in numbers. That's why it's splitting. That's why they're having congregations split all over America. There's an enormous exodus from the Episcopal Church because people know the Bible and know that action is wrong.
Reverend Robinson, how do you respond?
Well, one of the things I love being about being an Episcopalian is that we're not asked to check our brains at the door, and we're asked to use our brains even in interpreting Scripture. And all of us do interpret Scripture. And if we want to look at the Bible as a whole piece, that message is that God is love. And in the end, I believe that God's love will win out. The inclusive love of God will win out in our churches, and equal rights for all of Americans will win out in the society.
What Dennis? He really wants is for us to check not only our brains, as I said a moment ago, but to check our brains and our convictions so we go in the voting booth, we cannot vote the way we feel convictionally. He can go in the voting booth and he can vote based upon what his value is. I should be able to, as an American, to go in the voting booth and vote with a biblical framework if I choose to.